इज इट अपीयरिंग माई स्क्रीन? आर एबल टू सी माई स्क्रीन?
यस सर, नाउ वी कैन सी।
ओके, so last class, this was the last class. Now we are in the first problem. So this is the first problem, a cam with a 25 mm.
Sir?
Yeah.
My screen is not visible, sir.
My screen is not visible. Let me check. Now, is it visible now?
No, sir.
Other people?
Right, same thing. We can see, sir. We can see.
You can, John, I think you have problem. You turn on, you turn off your incoming video. So see the question here. A cam with 25 mm. A cam with 25 mm minimum radius. So cam is the dimensions of base circle is given 25 mm, and rotating in a clockwise direction at a uniform speed of this much of speed is given 100 rpm and has to give the motion to the knife edge follower. So what type of follower is given in the question? Knife edge follower is given. Now here the cam is given the motions to the follower. Here four steps given. Follower to move outward through 20 mm during the first 120 degrees of rotation of cam. It means the cam is the follower is going to rise upward with a height of 25 mm. Okay, now during the first cam rotation of 120 degrees, the first point. Now what is the second point? Follower dwell means follower doesn't having the any motion, means upward motion, not downward motion, means it is resting silently. Okay, resting means silently, it is not carrying any upward and downward motions. So that is a dwell here, dwell for the next 60 degrees of cam rotation. Okay, now what is the third one? Third one is the follower to return to its starting position. Returning means falling. Follower is falling from the top to bottom. So at the first stage, it is raised up the at 25 mm height. After that, the follower is dwell. Then what is the third point? The third point is follower is returning to the its original position. Original position means its initial position, means from the top to bottom it is falling. So how much dimension it is falling? 25 mm. When it is falling? During the next 90 degrees of cam rotation. Okay, now fourth one is the follower to dwell for the rest of the cam rotation. So how much rest of the cam rotation? So first we need to add it means total 360 degrees are the cam rotation. Okay, so in this we need to subtract first 120 degrees plus next 60 degrees plus next 90 degrees. So what, how much total how much, Babu? 120 plus 60, 180 plus 90. So 260, 360 minus 260, that is 100 degrees. Is it right?
Sir, 270.
Okay, 270 means 90 degrees. 270 means this is the 90 degrees. Okay, so what is the rest of the cam rotation? Here a statement given, rest of the cam rotation. How much rest of the cam rotation? That we calculated here, 90 degrees. okay, rest of the cam rotation 90 degrees. Means for the last 90 degrees of rotation of the cam, the follower is dual period. Means the fourth position is dual. Dual for the 90 degree. It means first rising is for the 120 degrees, dual for the 60 degrees, again falling for the 90 degrees, and for again dual for the 90 degrees. This is the meaning of the these four points. Okay. Now the displacement. Here the displacement of the follower, displacement of the follower takes place with uniform. Displacement of the follower is taking the uniform acceleration and retardation. Uniform acceleration and retardation on both. On both. See the statement properly. On both the outward and return strokes. It means both side we need to take the uniform acceleration and as well as retardation. Okay. Now question is asking to draw the cam profile. Draw the cam profile. First position. The follower axis passes through the axis of the cam. It means inline. It is the inline. Inline means axis of the follower is always passing through the axis of the cam. Now what is the second case? The second case is the follower axis is offset. Follower axis is offset by 10 mm. Offset by 10 mm from the axis of the cam. It means the second type is the offset follower. Offset follower. It means the question A and B is given based on the position of the axes. This one we studied in the classification of the followers. This one we studied in the classification of the followers. Okay. Now question is additionally asking here, determine the maximum velocity. So that maximum velocity and acceleration during outward and return stroke. So for the maximum velocity and for the acceleration, I given the relations. So write the relations here, apply the whatever the parameters are there. Easily you can get the maximum velocity as well as maximum acceleration. Okay. Now we start with that. First displacement diagram. The solution is, answer is radius of the cam is given 25 mm, given data you need to write Babu. For given data also you have marks, don't forget to write the given data. 25 mm radius and uniform speed n value is given 100 rpm. Okay, follower, what type of follower? Knife edge follower. Okay. And for the outward, for outward 25 mm, outward through 25 mm for the first 120 degrees and dwell for 60 degrees of cam rotation and return through 25 mm, 90 degrees of cam rotation, and the last final dwell is 90 degrees of cam rotation. So outward means outward stroke, return means return stroke. Okay, dwell means follower not having the any motions. It means outward motion, return motion. Okay, remember dwell means rest position. So here we need to, after writing the given data, we need to first construct the displacement diagram. The first step is blindly remember. First step is constructing the displacement diagram. Displacement diagram. First step, after writing the given data, you need to draw the first displacement diagram. So for the drawing the displacement diagram, what parameters we required? We required the horizontal axis length. We required the horizontal axis length and we required the vertical axis length, isn't it? These two are the mainly required for the drawing the displacement diagram. So how much axis length, we don't know that one. So here, this displacement diagram contains the four stages. What are those? See, question is given. This is the first stage. This is the second stage. This is the third stage. This is the fourth stage. The displacement contains the four stages. First stage is the outward through 25 mm. So this 25 mm represents the stroke length. 25 mm represents the stroke length. So take the scale, measure the 25 mm. 25 mm means our scale is available in centimeter. So how much it 25 mm means? How much centimeter? How much, Amma?
2.5.
So 2.5 centimeter. Measure on the scale and draw the vertical line. Now the question is, what is the horizontal length? So for the calculating the horizontal length, first stage I am considering 120 degrees. Suppose I already explained about this one, to convert, how to convert the degrees into centimeters. So for 20 degrees, 1 centimeter. So for 120 degrees, this is I am assuming for 20 degrees, I am taking the scales. For 20 degrees, 1 centimeter. Now what is the 120 degrees? How many centimeter? What is the value? So 120 by 20. So it means how much? 6 centimeters. So measure on the scale and measure the 6 centimeter line here. Okay. So after measuring the 6 centimeter, draw the vertical line. Now after calculating the 6 centimeter, divide this first part to 6 equal parts. Divide the first part equal to six equal parts. So 6 equal parts are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So see here, question here mentioning what type of, we have the four different types of displacement diagrams. Four displacement diagrams we have. So among the four displacement diagram, which one we need to draw? That is the question mark, isn't it? So see here, question, the displacement of the follower. Question here mentioning displacement of the follower. What type of displacement? Uniform acceleration and retardation. Here question is mentioning uniform acceleration and retardation. So that reason, because question is mentioning, I am drawing the displacement diagram with uniform acceleration and retardation. So what is the procedure? I already explained in the previous class. So that procedure you need to adapt here. Okay. So that procedure I'm again explaining here. First draw the horizontal line with a 6 centimeter line for the first stage, and vertical line as a stroke length as a 2.5 centimeter is given in the question. And
means what, sir?
Retardation means decreasing the speed. As a acceleration means rate of change of velocity. Same manner, retardation is opposite meaning. Opposite meaning to the acceleration. Okay. So
the displacement diagram we are drawing should be interesting with respect to the first condition only. So means 25 mm and 120 degree.
Yeah. For displacement diagram having the four stages. First stage, first point. This is the first stage. This first stage, whatever you're drawing, that is totally depends upon the first point. For the second stage, second point. Third point. Fourth stage, fourth point of the question. Okay. So after taking the 6 centimeter here, this is a 6 centimeter, and this is a 2.5 centimeter, and divide the this horizontal line into 6 equal parts. After dividing, because I'm drawing that this is uniform acceleration and retardation. Okay, so that procedure I'm drawing, showing here. Now divide this one into 2 equal parts like this. Again divide this one into 2 equal parts. Okay, now give the names 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now divide this vertical line into 6 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So give the names A, B, C, D, E. Okay. A, B, C, D, E. And finally is F. Now, draw the vertical line through the first point like this, through the second point like this, through the third point already drawn, and from the fourth point, draw like this, from the fifth point, draw like this. Okay, so displacement diagram, cam profile with the, you need to draw an examination with the pencil, not with pen. Okay, for this kinematics of machinery, whatever the equipment means stationary required for the drawing, you need to all carry the, these are all things, pencil, compass, divider, eraser, these are all things you need to carry it your, along with your exam hall ticket and other things. Okay, now join the O to A point, join the, draw the one line from the origin O to A point, same manner O to B, in same manner O to C. Okay, now you write the names here, 4, 5, 6. Now draw the line from the sixth point to C like this, from the D to 5, sorry, from these D to 6 and E to 6. Now the first lines are intersecting here, the second line is intersecting here, it means this is a second line, this is a second line, both are intersecting here, the third lines are intersecting, means this is the third line passing here and this is the third line passing here, both are intersecting here, and this is the fourth line passing here and this is the fourth line passing here, this is the fifth line, this is the sixth line, like this. Okay, now whatever the point you noted here, showing here, note the that point with the numericals, 1-2-, this is a 3-, this is a 4-, this is a 5-, this is a 6-. Okay, now join the all points with the free hands, all points with the free hand. So in examination, draw the this line. I am drawing here darken. Okay, in this manner only you need to draw in the examination. Means answer should be dark. In this diagram, which one is the answer? The dark line is the answer. Okay, remember this one. The dark line is the answer. So this is the first stage. So first stage means first point is given in the question, 25 mm. 120 degrees of cam rotation. So for the 120 degrees of cam rotation, 120 degrees of cam rotation, this is the one. What is the curve meaning here? The displacement of the follower. What is the curve meaning here? For the first cam rotation of 120 degrees, the displacement of the follower. The displacement curve should be, will come like this. Okay. Now, what is the second point? The second point is given in the question, dwell for the next 60 degrees of cam rotation. Dwell means it is not having any motion. So how much 60 degrees of cam rotation? 60 degrees means convert the 60 degrees into centimeters. So centimeters means I consider 20 degrees as a 1 centimeter. So for the 60 degrees, how many? So 3 centimeter. This is a 3 centimeter. It means measure on the scale 3 centimeter and place here. Okay. Place here, draw vertical line. Now show the dwell period. Dwell means follower not having any motion, means outward motion and return motion. Okay, for that reason I am drawing the straight line. For that reason I am drawing the straight line. It means, see that here straight line means, if it is curve, we can say that the follower having a somewhat motion like this in first stage. Here it is a straight line, means the straight line indicating follower not having, doesn't having any motions. Okay, so this is the follower for the next 60 degrees of cam rotation. That is the second point. Now what is the third point? Third point is the follower returns to its starting position, initial position during the next 90 degrees of cam rotation. Next 90 degrees means how much centimeter? 90 by 20. So how much it is? 4.5 centimeter. So 4.5 centimeter you need to show here. Okay, suppose it is here 4.5. okay, measure 4.5 centimeters and draw the line. First draw the one point and draw vertical line. Now this box also you need to divide 6 equal parts. This one, the second, the third box also you need to divide the 6 equal parts, because it is returning to its initial position, means follower is having the somewhat motion. So for that reason 6 equal parts I am dividing, because in first stage we divided the 6 equal parts. Here also I am dividing the 6 equal parts. 1 2 3 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 equal parts I divided. Now then join the same procedure what you practice in the first box, same procedure you need to adapt here. But the thing is, remember one thing, while you're starting the numbering, giving the numbering, you start with the sixth number. Here, 6. Here it is the last point is 6. Here start with the 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here. Oh, sorry. 1, this is a 0. This is a 0. Now, same procedure. Divide this into two equal parts. Now, here also divide the two equal parts. Okay. Join the here top to bottom, here join here like this. It means the third diagram is mirror image of the first diagram, like the it should be appear as a mirror image of the first diagram. The third one is a appears, the third one should be appears as a mirror image. Okay, like that you need to draw. Now divide this also, the midline also equal parts. 1 2, this is a 3 4 5 6, giving the naming 1 A B C D E F. Now here draw the, join the line in this manner. Here it is in this manner, first line. Okay, in this manner. Now sixth line is touching here, fifth line is touching here, the fourth line is touching here, third line is touching here, second line is touching here, first line is touching here. This is a 0, and give the naming 6 dash 5 dash, sorry, this is the 6 dash, this is the 5 dash, this is a 4 dash, and this is a 3 dash 2 dash 1 dash 0 dash. Okay, now join the all points by free hand, join the all points by free hand. I said one thing, the third diagram should be mirror image of the first one, like that you need to draw. So in same manner the second diagram also come. So when it should be mirror image, it is not always, in not all cases, because here question is mentioning, see that uniform acceleration and retardation on both, on both, such type of statement when you observed, then only mirror image. Remember this point. If the question is mentioning on both outward and return strokes, on both return and outward stroke, means outward stroke same method is following, return is same method is following, when follower is following the outward stroke same, return stroke is same, then only you need to draw the like a mirror image. It means whatever the image appearing here in the first stage, that same image should be appear in the third also. Okay, this mirror image is not mirror image is not same at all cases. See the question and draw the according to the question. So this is the third stage. This is the third stage. What is that? 90 degrees of cam rotation. Okay. And what is the final rest of cam rotation? Rest of cam rotation, how much we calculated? 90 degrees. So for the 90 degrees, how many centimeters? For 90 degrees, just now we calculated 4.5. So measure the 4.5. That is the next 90 degrees. Measure 4.5 and draw one straight line with dark. Draw one straight line with the dark. Okay. So in the examination also, you need to draw same as it is how I shown on the screen. And don't show the centimeters line on the paper. Don't show the centimeter on the paper. Only you need to show on the paper in this manner. 120 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees like this. Here it is in a 2.5 centimeter. But for the horizontal, don't show the 6 centimeter, 4 centimeter, whatever the values you got here while conversion. Okay. Don't show the conversion values here. Just draw, show the 120 degrees, 60, 90. 90 like this. It is for all cases, for every problem. Okay. And the answer should be very dark. Whatever the dark line is appearing on your screen, in same manner you need to show on the paper. Okay. So this is the first diagram of the displacement for this question. For every question, you need to start with the displacement diagram. After writing the given data, you start with the displacement diagram. Okay, so this is the completion of the displacement diagram. Now I am going to the cam profile.
Sir, we have to first draw displacement diagram, then cam profile, sir.
Yeah, first we need to draw the displacement diagram. First we need to write the given data, then conversions. Whatever the conversions we written here, conversions. Then go to the first step. Displacement diagram. The second step is the cam profile.
Sir, in the third return, sir, the numbers will be 6-, 5-, 4-, and A-, B-, C-, sir.
Which one, Amma?
In the third return
stroke. Yeah. So same. 6-, 5-, 4-, 3-, 2-, means what I said, mirror image. Like this manner, it will come. It means you started the first stage 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. In return stroke, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this you need to write. So when you return the 6, 4, 5, 3, 2, 1, the respective values also like 6-, 5-, 4-, 3-, 2-, 1-, like that.
Okay.
Now this is a cam profile I'm drawing here. Cam profile. To draw the cam profile, first draw the base circle. How much base circle, cam base circle value is given in the question as a radius value is given 25 mm. So take the 25 mm on the scale, measure on the scale. Okay. Now take the compass, measure 25 mm radius and draw one circle. Take the compass, measure 25 mm radius and draw the one circle. Okay. What is the radius of the circle here? 25 mm. Okay. Now divide the circle into four equal parts. So I am dividing the circle into four equal parts. Okay. I divided. Now this is the vertical line representing the axis of the these two, not vertical, the horizontal and as well as vertical represents the axes for the circle. Okay, now I'm considering the vertical y-axis for this reference. So for that reason, I'm drawing the one axis line. Axis line I'm drawing here. So what is the axis line? Axis line not like this. On paper, you need to draw in this manner. One long length line, one short length line. One long length line, one short length line. In this manner, the representation of the axis line. Okay. Here it is not coming. For that reason, I'm drawing the dotted lines. This is the representation of the axis line. For this also, you have the marks. The examiner will focus on such things. Okay. This is the axis line. Okay, Babu. Now draw the follower. Yeah, tell me, Amma.
What is the difference between axis line and dotted lines?
Dotted line is used for the hidden lines. Suppose, see here, I want to draw one cube. Like this, I want to draw. So I have drawn. I want to see this backside line also. Backside line means. Like this. So this hidden means it is there behind this one. We can't see, but we want to see this. So at this time, we need to draw with the dotted lines. That is, these dotted lines are the known as hidden lines. For the hidden things, we are using this one. Axis line is whatever the line is passing centrally. That axis line we need to show. This axis line we need to use. I think this you studied on in engineering drawing. Conventional representation of lines. Thin line represents the dimensioning line. Okay. Now, what type of follower is given in the question? Knife edge follower. Question itself mentioning knife edge follower. So that reason I'm drawing the knife edge here. So this is the problem for the first case. What is the first case? Inline follower. Inline follower. Because question is mentioning axis follow. Follower axis passing through the cam axis. That is the inline follower. So here I am drawing the knife edge like this. Okay. This is the knife edge. Why I have drawn like this? Because the question is mentioned. This is the axis of the follower passing through the axis of the cam. It means axis of the follower, axis of the cam, both are coinciding. That is the inline follower. Okay. So whenever inline position is given in this manner, you need to construct. Now, first point is given for 120 degrees of cam rotation. Second point is given for 60 degrees of cam rotation. Third point is given 90 degrees of cam rotation. Fourth point is given 90 degrees. So here, divide this circle into these equal parts. For first time, 120, second, 60, third, 90, fourth, 90, like this. So this is the first two I'm drawing. From here to here, it is 90. Okay. To make 120 to 90, how much we need to add? 30 we need to add. It means this is the A point starting and this is the B. Okay. So from here to here, 120. Here to here, 90 plus 30, total 120. So through 120, the follower is rising up. Then what is that next 60 degrees? It means here to here 60 degrees. Here to here 60 degrees. So draw this like this. Now what is the third one? Third one is the 90 degrees. 90 degrees for falling period. So this is from here to here, it is 90 degrees. So like this I divided. Okay. Now, what is the rest of the cam? Dwell. So, rest of the cam, what is the resting here? Rest of the cam 90 degrees. So, like this, we divided. So, here, for first time 120 degrees. Here to here, 120 I divided. Second time 60. This is the second time 60. Third time 90. This is the third time. Last time is the 90 degrees. Now, after dividing, after dividing the four equal parts here, according to this one, according to this, we need to divide. Okay. Now, divide the 120 degrees duration. So, just wait. I am erasing this one. Okay. So this is the four parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So for the first period, how many parts we divided in the displacement for the first period? 120 degrees. For 120 degrees, this displacement diagram we divided into 6 equal parts. Isn't it? In same manner, for the here also, for 120 degrees duration, we need to divide this arc. We need to divide this arc into 6 equal parts. What is the reason why I'm dividing the 6 equal parts? Because for the in the displacement diagram, for the first stage, I divided the 6 equal parts. Because of that reason, I'm dividing the same number of equal parts here. So how much degree I need to maintain here? So 120 by 6. How much degree? 20 degree we need to maintain. 20. Okay, 20. So measure, take that D scale, place here, measure angles properly. Okay, 20 degrees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 20 degrees. Now after dividing, draw the lines. Like this. Like this, draw. So how much angle between each line? How much, anybody? How much the angle between
20,
each
20.
Line? Yeah, 20. Okay, now give the name. This is the one. This is the one point. This is the second point. This is the third point. 4, 5, 6. Give the name. Now for the second stage, go to the displacement diagram. Second stage, what we are doing? We are doing nothing here. Simply we are drawing the straight line. It means leave the second B2 C as it is. Don't do anything there. Okay. Now again go to the displacement diagram. See the in the third stage. Here we are. What we are doing? We are dividing this line into 6 equal parts. Okay, in same manner, we need here also we need to divide the C to D also we need to divide 6 equal parts. So how much each equal part? It means total angle is 90 degrees, 90 by 6. So how much it is? 90 by 6 means how much angle? 90 by 6 means 90 by 6 is each angle, each part is 15 degrees. Each angle is, it means angle between the each line is 15 degrees. So by maintaining the 15 degrees, keep the D scale here and measure the 15 degrees and draw the lines, divide the points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now giving the name is reverse manner. Why? Because in the displacement diagram, we given the naming 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 like that. So for that reason, here also, we need to give the naming in reverse manner. That is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. In this manner, we need to give the namings. Okay, this is a 0. Now draw the lines. The lines should be passes through these points. Okay. Now take the compass. After now the final. What is the final? The fourth one is the 90 degrees. For the 90 degrees, what we are doing in the displacement diagram in the last stage, we are doing nothing here. Simply we are drawing this straight line. Okay. So for that reason, in the CAM profile also, don't do anything here. Leave it as it is. Okay. Now take the compass. Take the compass. Go to the displacement diagram. Go to the displacement diagram. Here, for the first point O, there is no difference. There is no distance. Okay, leave it. Now, here measure the with the compass. How much distance is there from the first point to 11 dash point? First point to 11 dash. How much distance is there? Measure with the compass. Are you getting or not? Okay. If you any difficulties there, please ask me. Measure, take the compass, measure the distance between the first point and one dash point. Okay, measure and come to the CAM profile. Come to the CAM profile and keep the needle of the compass on the first point here. Keep the needle of the compass on the first point here and cut the arc on the first line. Which one is the first line? The line whichever is passing through the first point, that is the first line. Cut the arc on the first line like this. Now give the name 1 dash. Is it okay?
So what is the distance?
The distance is here in this diagram. See, displacement in displacement diagram, how much distance is there from the first point to 1 dash point? I don't know how much it is there. You need to measure on the compass by using the compass. Okay, keep here needle of the compass at this point and pencil needle keep here. Take the measurement and come to the CAM profile. Okay, come to the CAM profile. Again, keep the needle of the compass on the first point and cut the arc on the first line. Now, second time, go to the again CAM displacement diagram. Go to again displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass on the second point here. Keep the needle of the compass on the second point. Keep the needle of the pencil on the second point here. It's 2 dash. Compass needle on the second point. Pencil needle on the 2 dash. How much distance is there? Measure. After measuring, come to the CAM profile. After measuring, come to the CAM profile. Keep the here. Here, keep the needle of the compass on the second point here. Okay, cut the arc on second line. Which one is the second line? The line is whichever is passing through the second point, that is the second line. So this is the line is passing through the second point. So this is the second line. Okay, cut the arc on the second point. It means keep the needle of the compass here. Okay, and cut the arc on second point, second line. Like this. Give the name 2 dash. Now again go to the displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass on the third point. Keep the needle of the compass on the third point and keep the pencil needle on the 3 dash here. Okay. Now come to the CAM profile. Come to the CAM profile. Keep the needle of the needle on the third point here. Here, okay. Now cut the arc on third line. Cut the arc on third line. This is the third line. Like this. Why I am calling this is the third line? Because this line is passing through the third point. Okay. Cut the arc on third line like this. And after cutting the arc, give the name 3 dash. Now same manner, again go to the displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass on fourth point. Keep the needle of the compass on fourth point and keep the needle of the pencil on the four dash line, four dash point. Measure the distance four dash. Again, come to cam profile. Keep the needle of the compass on the fourth point and cut the arc on fourth line, give the name as 4 dash. Again, go to displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass on the fifth point and keep the needle of the pencil on the fifth dash, 5 dash. Measure the distance between these two and come to cam profile. Come to cam profile, keep the needle of the compass on the fifth point here and cut the arc on fifth line. Give the name as 5 dash. Okay. Again, go to cam displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass sixth point and keep the pencil needle at the sixth dash. Measure the distance sixth dash and come to cam profile. And keep the compass needle at the sixth point here. Cut the arc on the sixth line in this manner. Give the name as 6 dash. Is it okay, Babu? Dividing how to cut the arc on the lines?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, go to the cam profile again. Sorry, displacement diagram. See then second stage. What you are doing? Nothing you are doing. Levity. Now come to the third stage. In third stage, what you are doing? You are doing something here. Dividing and cutting the arc. Okay? So come to the third stage. Keep the needle of the compass on the sixth point. Keep the needle of the compass on sixth point. And pencil needle on six dash. Measure the distance. Now go to the cam profile. See here I'm doing. For the second stage, I'm not doing anything because in displacement diagram also, we didn't do anything. Now here, after measuring the 6-6 dash, keep the needle of the compass on 6th point and cut the arc on 6th line like this. Give the name 6 dash. Okay. Now go to the displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass on the fifth point and keep the pencil needle at the 5 dash point. Go to cam profile. 5 compass needle on 5 and cut the arc on fifth line, that is 5 dash. Go to displacement diagram again. Keep the needle of the compass on fourth point and keep the pencil needle on the 4 dash. Measure the distance and go to the cam profile. Keep the needle of the compass on the fourth point here and cut the arc on fourth line. This is the 4 dash. Give the name. Again, go to the displacement diagram. Keep the needle of the compass on third point. Okay. Now keep the pencil needle at the 3 dash point. Now after measuring 3 dash, come to the cam profile. Now keep the needle of the compass here, third point, and cut the arc on third line like this. Okay. Again, go to the displacement diagram. Measure 2 dash distance. Come to cam profile. Keep the needle of the compass here and cut the arc on second line. Give the name 2 dash, 1 dash. This is a 0. Like this, we need to cut the arc on the lines. Okay. After cutting the arc, see here for the fourth, go to the displacement diagram. For the last stage, we are doing nothing here. So for that reason, the A2D also don't do anything, leave it as it is. Now, indicating the 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, like that, join the all points by free hand. free hand. So I'm drawing like here. See here. 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6. Again 6 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 1, 1 to 0. Again 0 to 0. This is the answer. Which one is the answer? The dark line again I'm drawing. Whatever the by free hand you are joining the all point, all points, that is the answer for this question. So in exam also you need to draw dark line. If you forget to draw the dark line, the examiner will get confused and will not give the marks. Okay, and pentab it is unable to draw properly, but it will be good on papers. Okay, so this is the CAM profile for the knife edge follower as per the given data. As per the given data. Now this
so is you can give the dimensions of follower also.
Yeah, here in this inside I have written 120, 60, 90, 90 like that. You need to draw show.
Yes, a follower
dimensions will not given. Just type of follower shape is will be given in the question. What shape here? Knife edge shape is given. So for that, knife edge follower. Like this, you need to write. So the dark line is the CAM profile that you need to show. CAM profile. Profile. This is the base circle. Base circle. Base circle. How much radius? Radius 25 mm. So in this manner, you need to draw the diagram. Don't write the procedure for the displacement as well as CAM profile. What you need to do? First, you need to write the for the this type of problems. First, you need to write the given data. Then go to displacement diagram. Then CAM profile. If you show these three things, the answer will complete. Don't write extra things. Okay. Now, is there any doubt? Is there how to draw the arc? How to divide the lines?
So the base circle itself, we have to take it into convert into centimeter and draw the circle, right? Base circle.
Yeah. Because our scale is available in a centimeter, na. Yes. It is available in mm. Don't need to divide. Don't need to convert. So, is there any doubt in displacement and in the CAM profile? Is it clear? If it is clear, I will go to next.
Yes, sir.
Let me check anybody engaged in the class. If anybody not engaged, I will continue. Okay. Nobody is there, I think. Only my class is appearing here. So shall I continue?
Yes, sir.
How many students are there? 21 students are there. Jan Baba, is it clear? Any doubts? Jan Baba.
He's not there, sir.
His photo is appearing here. Rule number 4.
Chandu, sir. Chandu, Chandu.
Oh, Chandu Lal. Okay. Chandu Baba, any doubts?
Sir.
Ah.
No doubt, sir. It is clear.
Atif Babu.
No, sir. No doubts. Clear.
I know the only A section names. So the reason continually I'm asking for A section people. Okay. So this is the procedure for this.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, are we given any white sheets for drawing these, or on rule paper only we have to draw?
Actually, it should be given for the exam of CAM and drawing this CAM profile and displacement diagram. But I don't know in Usmanian City whether they will give or they will not give, because first time I am working in this Usmanian Affiliated College. I will inform you in next class whether they will provide or don't provide. I will inform you.
Okay, sir. Because if we draw on rule paper, it will be messy, sir. Even there is a chance of the examiner won't understand it.
Yeah. I will inform you in next class.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Now, the second question. What is the first question? The first question is follower axis. The first question is follower axis passes through the axis of the CAM. Because of that reason only, I have drawn like this. Follower axis passing through the axis of the CAM. Now, second question is, follower axis is here. Follower axis is offset by right. Offset by right. How much offsetting? 10 mm. How much? 10 mm. Okay. That I am drawing here. Now, see the procedure. First, draw the circle. How much radius? Radius is given in the question, 25 mm. Take the compass, measure 25 mm, draw the circle. So what is the diameter of the circle now? What is the diameter?
50 mm.
75 mm.
50 mm, sir. 50 mm. 25 mm radius is 50 mm.
Sorry, what is the diameter of the circle here?
50 mm.
Yeah. Yeah. After, so see, I'm drawing somewhat large. Okay, measure the radius with compass and draw the circle 50 mm diameter. Okay, now after drawing the circle, draw the axis, vertical axis here. Vertical axis. Okay, now measure offset. How much is given? 10 mm offset by right. So this is the right side. 10 mm I'm measuring. Okay, 10 mm. This is another point. Okay, measure right side. Because the question itself mentioning that right side offset is at 10 mm. So that reason I am taking the right side as a 10 mm. Okay. Now, after measuring the 10 mm, this is the point. Now take the compass and keep the needle of the compass here as a center, and this is a radius. Draw another circle. Okay, draw another circle. Now through this point, draw another axis line. Okay, draw another axis line. Now draw the follower here. What type of follower is given in the question? Knife edge follower is given in the question. So knife edge should be appear like this in here. It means the axis of the follower is offset to the cam. How much? 10 mm. How much? 10 mm. Okay. Now, question is given 4 points. First 120 degrees, second 60 degrees, third one 90 degrees, fourth one 90 degrees.
Parang sir, class?
Yes, Babu. Yes. Somebody asking doubt?
No, sir, no.
Okay. So, after showing the offset, divide the circle into 4 parts. How many parts? 4 parts. Because the question is mentioning 4 parts. First one, first part is the 120 degrees. So, first one is a 120 degrees. So, dividing with respect to the center, not here. Remember that one. Dividing with respect to this center, not with this one. Okay. Dividing with this center, not with this one. Now, divide first 120 degrees. It means here to here 90. And if we make 30 degrees extra. Okay. This is a total 120 degrees.
But this circle we have drawn with the offset of 10 millimeters. Inside.
Yeah, yeah. This one, small circle with the 10 mm radius. Now, what is the next one? Next one is 60 degrees. So, measure 60 degrees. Measure 60 degrees. Draw another line. And 90 degrees means here to here measure 90 degrees. Draw another line. And rest is the 90 degrees. Okay. Now, after dividing, what you need to do? Go to the displacement diagram. See for the first period how many parts it is divided. How many parts it is divided? 6 equal parts it is divided. After class, 6 equal parts it is divided. So same number of parts you need to divide here. So from here to this is the point A. Point A. This is the point B, C, and D. Okay. ఎక్స్ట్రా తీసుకుంటున్నా ఎవరు లేరు కదా ఒక యూనిట్ అయిపోతుంది రివిజన్ క్లాసెస్ ఓకే సారీ బాబు డివైడింగ్ హియర్ ఫ్రమ్ ది Wait, I'm again showing. I did one mistake. Listen once again. After drawing the offset, join the A point to the center. Join this knife edge to center. After joining this line, measure 120 degrees. Measure 120 degrees from this line. Okay. Now after measuring, somewhere it is here. Like this. Okay. After drawing this line, measure 60 degrees, draw another line like this. After drawing the 60 degrees, this line, measure 90 degrees, it will somewhere here. Like this, it will come. Now, divide this A to B into six equal parts. Six equal parts means how much equal part? 20, 20, 20, like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, give the names. This is a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? After drawing, dividing the points, join the all points to the small circle in tangent manner. Which one is a small circle? This is a small circle here, offset circle. Okay? Join the all points to the circle in tangent manner. Tangent manner means in this manner. Like this. Tangent means, Babu? In this manner. Like this. Are you getting? Like this, tangent means. In this manner, you need to draw here. It means this is the one. Because this is a small circle, is not come round circle. So that reason it is not appearing properly. In this tangent manner, you need to draw. In this manner, you need to draw. Now, same procedure what you did in the first, in this process. Here in this process, 1-1 dash, 2-2 dash, 3-3 dash.
Tangent to the small circle, sir.
The tangent to small circle. Here, this is a small circle. Yes. Here, this is a small circle. So, all lines should be tangent to the small circle. Tangent means in this manner. Separately, I have drawn here. Tangent means this is the meaning. Okay. After drawing the tangent line, measure the distance in the displacement diagram 1-1 dash. Here, please mute yourself. Measure the distance with the compass 1-1 dash. With the compass, keep the needle of the compass 1 and pencil needle at 1 dash. Measure the distance, come to cam profile. Okay, come to cam profile. Keep the needle of the compass here, cut the arc on 1 dash. Same manner, 2-2 dash, 2-2 dash, 3-3 dash, 4-4 dash, 5-5 dash, 6-6 dash, like this. Okay, same procedure what we did in the previous topic, inline cam. Same procedure we are adapting. Only additional thing is drawing the tangent to the smallest circle. And rest of the things are all same. Now, for the B to C, we are doing nothing in displacement diagram. So, leave it as it is. Now, C to D, we are dividing in the third stage, six equal parts. So, six equal parts means, third one is 90 degrees. 90 degrees means 90 by 6 equal parts, it means 15. Each degree is 15 degrees. Maintain the 15 degrees each part. Divide the 6 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts we divided. Now start with the numbering 6. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Now, through these points, draw the tangent to the smallest circle. It means like this here. This is the tangent for the sixth one. This is tangent for the fifth one. This is tangent for the fourth one. This is tangent for the third one. This is tangent to the second one. This is tangent to the first point. This is tangent to the last point. Like this, we need to draw the tangent line. Yeah, ma.
Sir, the tangents will be not as perfect as a straight line, sir, right? There's no problem, no, sir. Because the tangent, we have to take it approximately because it will be not perfect.
Yeah.
So there'll be no problem with the camera.
But whatever you are drawing tangent, that tangent line should be passes through these points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? And the thing is, whether it is exactly making the tangent or not, that is not a matter. But here it is passing through the point, that is a matter here.
Okay, sir.
So they all should pass through one point, sir.
Not point one point. What is the meaning tangent?
Yes, sir, I know. It's just touch the point of the circle. But you, from here, you are taking all the one point, no, sir.
Because here is the smallest circle is not continuous circle. Here I am unable to draw on the screen properly. If we use the pencil scale with that entire stationary, we can draw properly. Okay, so it should be the tangent means, see, it should be like this. Okay, now same procedure, 6-6-5-4-3-2-1-0. Are you getting how I making the cutting the arc here? How I am cutting the arc?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 6- means go to the displacement diagram. Go to the displacement diagram. Okay. Here, keep the needle of the compass 6. Pencil needle 6-. Measure 6-6-. Come to cam profile. Come to cam profile. Keep the needle of the compass at 6th point. Cut the arc on the 6th line, give the name as 6-. Repeat the same procedure to 1st point till the reaching the 1st point. Now after getting the 1-2-3-, join the all points by free hand. Join the all points by free hand like this. Three, four, five, six. Again, see here. The curve should be curve manner only bound. There is no irregularity. If you getting the irregularity, examiner simply will give 0 marks. Irregularity means whatever you are seeing on the screen, that is the irregularity. Okay, so the answer is a dark line. The answer is the dark line. So this is the offset follower with knife edge. This is a offset by 10 mm. Offset by 10 mm. Okay. The dark line is a cam profile. Cam profile. The smallest is this. This is the base circle. Base circle with radius 25 mm. Okay. Like this, you need to draw on the paper. Don't write the any construction points. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Sir, can you explain once again how to draw inner circle, sir? But
this smallest circle, Babu.
Yes, sir.
So first to draw the large circle, then draw the one vertical axis line like this. I'm drawing here. First draw the base circle, then draw the axis line through the this axis line is passing to the center of the circle. Okay, after drawing, go to the question. Offsetting how much? 10 mm in sometimes. It will 15 mm, 20 mm, 25 mm, otherwise 8 mm, like this it will given in the question. This all are the offset values. Go see the offset value, how much it is given, and direction also important, whether it is right side or left side. If it is mentioned left side, measure this side, because question is given in this here, right side. So measure 10 mm, right side, make a point, and take the compass. Keep the needle of the compass center here and pencil needle here. Draw one circle. That is the procedure for drawing the offset circle. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So the notes I have already shared through the MS Teams. You go through the whatever the questions are there. You practice that questions. If you get any doubts, write it on paper. All doubts, whatever, not simple one question. You read the, you practice the all problems and note it down, any doubts you are raising, write it on paper, and when I am taking the next class, you ask one by one. Okay. Don't leave the class. I am taking the attendance.
One more question is there, no, sir? In this question, sir, a maximum acceleration, something.
Yeah. I forgot. Explaining. Wait. Very good.
And sir, one more thing, sir. So, how many types of followers are there, sir? Like in this inline and offset, right? On all questions, we have to. We'll be having these two types only, sir.
Mm-hmm. Follower types I have explained in the beginning of the CAM unit. Types of CAMs, types of follower. Followers are categories based on the position, based on the working, based on the shape. I explained these are all things. Based on the shape means if it is appears as a knife edge, that is knife edge follower. If it is a surface appearing roller, that is roller follower. The surface appearing as a mushroom, that is mushroom follower. Motion axis position means in an offset. These two are the according to position. Third one is a oscillating follower, reciprocating follower. These are all things explained in the first class. You go through that one. Now question is maximum velocity, maximum acceleration for the both return stroke and outward stroke. Okay. The maximum velocity. First question is maximum velocity. Maximum velocity during outward stroke. During outward stroke. Who is Vaishnavi? He is asking some question. Is there Vaishnavi? Okay. Maximum velocity for the maximum velocity for uniform acceleration and retardation, go through that notes what I shared. Okay, the velocity and acceleration equations are different for the different motions. Okay, I am writing the equation for the uniform acceleration and retardation. Okay, 2 omega into displacement by angle of rotation of cam. So how much angle I need to take here? So four angles are there. First one is a 120 degrees, second one is a 60 degrees, third one is a 90 degrees, fourth one is the 90 degrees. Four angles are there. This is for the outward stroke, this is dwell, this is return stroke, this is the dwell. Okay, so among the four, which one I need to select? See the here, outward stroke. Question is mentioning outward stroke means this theta value I have to take 120. Theta value I have to take 120 degrees. 120. Sir, not 122 degrees. This 120 degree you need to convert into radians. 120 into pi by 180. 120 into pi by 180. 180. Okay, omega value how much given? Omega value 2 pi n 60, angular velocity 2 pi n by 60. So n value is given in the question. How much? How much n value at the beginning?
100, sir.
100 rpm. 100, sir. 100 rpm is given in the question right here. And displacement nothing but stroke length. Stroke length how much given? 25 mm given. Question value 25 mm given stroke length. So convert this 25 mm into meters. 0 point. How much convert? 0.025. 0.025. Why I am converting? Why I am converting? Anybody? What is the units of velocity? Meters per second. So that reason I am converting this one. Okay. So what is the maximum velocity?
So the stroke length and the radius of cam will be same, sir.
Yeah. What is the answer? Make it fast. What is the answer? 2 into, first we calculate omega separately and theta separately and then substitute. How much it is? I think around 2.8. Between the answer will come. Calculate the answer will between these two, 2.2 to 2.8.
So how did you get stroke length, sir? Stroke length?
Stroke length is given in the question. Stroke length is nothing but displacement of the follower. Y-axis value is the stroke length. Diagram, y-axis value is the stroke length.
Okay.
Sir, 2.39, sir.
2.39. Answer is 2.39 means 2.4 I am writing meter per second. Maximum velocity for the outward stroke. Now what is that one? Next one, maximum acceleration for outward stroke. What is the equation? The equation, acceleration equation is 4 omega square into displacement by theta square. So this equation also, you need to remember one thing, Babu. Whatever the equations I'm writing, that equations are related to follower motion. What type of follower motion is given in the question?
Uniform
acceleration and retardation. So related to that only I am taking the equations here. Okay, 4 omega square into displacement theta square. Displacement value how much given in the question? 0.025. Omega value how much you got? Omega value 2 pi by 60. Theta value how much you got? Value here 120 into pi by 180. Whole square. So why I'm taking the 120 here? Because the title itself showing outward stroke. At outward stroke, what is the acceleration of the cam and what is the acceleration of the follower? That is the meaning. So what is the value, acceleration value? What is that? Make it fast. Please mute yourself. How much the value? This you're taking too much time. Meter per second square.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
So the above value is coming 0.24, sir.
Which one?
Maximum velocity.
0.24. Not 0.24, Babu. How it will come? You recheck again. So see, like this only we'll get the, we'll lose the marks. While doing calculation, be sharp. Now, maximum velocity for return stroke. Maximum velocity for return stroke. Return stroke. Maximum acceleration for return stroke. Why I'm taking return stroke? Because question is asking. Maximum velocity V is equal to omega into displacement by theta. Here acceleration A is 4 omega square into displacement by theta square. Okay, here omega is a 2 pi by 60 as you calculated earlier this value. displacement is at 0.025. theta value, how much theta value will going to change here? 90 degrees, because in return stroke, what is the value? 90 degrees. What is the theta value when it follow returning? 90 degrees. So that reason theta value is going to change here. Here also same as it is. Omega is a 2π/60, and displacement is a 0.025, and theta is the value is going to change. That is 90 × π/180. Here in our question, two 90s are appearing. Which 90 we need to select? Two 90 degrees are appearing. Which 90 we need to take? The third 90 degrees that we need to take. Because when the follower is coming to its original position in return stroke, it is coming to the its original position. That degree value we need to take. I think you are getting confusing. First is the 120 degrees arising, means outward direction, outward stroke. Second one is a dwell. Third one is a return stroke. Fourth one is a dwell. So this 90 degrees sir, value we need to take. Yeah.
Sir, dwell means rest position, huh?
Yeah, dwell means rest position. Okay, Babu. Return stroke angle, this is the one. Outward stroke angle, this is the one. This is for the outward stroke. This is for the return stroke. Okay.